Today we brought the Big Shaker to Seattle to help people to understand just how dangerous an earthquake underneath their feet could be. You guys are seriously overdue for a major earthquake, so we want you guys to get prepared before, because an earthquake here in Seattle, trust me, it could happen just like that. Earthquake that large, it's gonna go not for seconds, guys, for minutes.
It's eye-opening. Even though I've been through an earthquake myself back in 2001 with the Nisqually, it serves as a reminder, like, oh yeah, I need to do some retrofitting in my house.
So in a major earthquake, what's gonna happen to the items on the walls or the shelves? You're gonna fall off, right? Break, broken glass.
One thing you see in the trailer is that objects fall. So when we're out in the community doing training, a lot of it's around how do you secure objects in your home to make sure you reduce the risk of injuries. But then after the shaking stops, we know that transportation will be disrupted, utilities will be disrupted, stores may not be open, all of the things you normally rely on aren't necessarily going to be there. So those preparedness steps that we really focus on are with that in mind.
It's not if, but when. It's serious. I want people to be prepared. And if you go to our City of Seattle Emergency Management website, we have a lot of great information on how to sign up for Alert Seattle, how to prepare an earthquake kit, and how to get connected with local volunteers who are organizing. I just got a chance to sit through the earthquake shaker. It is really a shake.
Wow.
I have an earthquake kit, but I realized today I need to go secure my bookcases to the wall because they could fall and hurt someone in my family.
Yeah, it was fun to do it, and I know this could happen anytime and I could be anywhere. Going through this today, I'll probably be more purposeful now about getting all my supplies in.
If it never happens, great, but I would rather be prepared in advance for my family than have to explain to my wife and children why I didn't take a couple minutes of my time to get them prepared and to safeguard our home and our belongings.
I mean, I think that the challenge in reaching people always is falling somewhere between scaring them and having too much fun. But it can be dry, so it's good to add an element of fun to it. That's what's gonna get people interested, hopefully get them to take action.
Get prepared now before it's too late, all right? Everybody pick up 3-4 things, and then we'll knock them down again.